Hey there, beautiful ladies and gentlemen. My name is Zane Owen, and I hope you all are having a fantastic day today. And welcome to Five Nights at Freddy's. Now you might be wondering, Zane, why the frick are you playing this again? And then you might ask, what about Ultimate Custom Night? Shut up. See, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go through each and every single Five Nights at Freddy's game and complete them until we get to Ultimate Custom Night. That, I know for sure, we can do. There? Does that sound good? Sounds good? Okay. New game! Family Beats Real looking for security guard to work night shift 12 to 6 a.m. Yeah. Everybody already knows this. Also, I apologize if you can't really see me, by the way. I'm recording all these episodes in like one take, so. Oh, there he is. Okay.
I actually worked in that office before you. I'm finishing up my last week now, as a matter of fact. So
okay.
I know it can be a bit overwhelming, but I'm here to tell you there's nothing to worry about. You'll be fine. So let's just focus on getting you through your first week, okay? Let's see. First, there's an introductory greeting from the company that I'm supposed to read. It's kind of a legal thing, you know. Welcome to Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, a magical place for kids and grown-ups alike, where fantasy and fun come to life. Fazbear Entertainment is not responsible for damage to property or person. Upon discovering that damage or death has occurred, a missing person report will be filed within 90 days or as soon as property and premises have been thoroughly cleaned and bleached and the carpets have been replaced. Blah, blah, blah. Now, that might sound bad, I know, but there's really nothing to worry about. The animatronic characters here do get a bit quirky at night, but do I blame them? No. If I were forced to sing those same stupid songs for 20 years and I never got a bath, I'd probably be a bit irritable at night too. So remember, these characters hold a special place in the hearts of children, and we need to show them a little respect, right? Okay. So just be aware, the characters do tend to wander a bit. They're left in some kind of roaming mode at night.
Mm-hmm.
Something about their servers locking up if they get turned off for too long. They used to be allowed to walk around during the day, too. But then there was the bite of 87. Yeah. It's amazing that the human body can live without the frontal lobe, you know? Now, concerning your safety, the only real risk to you as a night watchman there, if any, is the fact that these characters, if they happen to see you after hours, probably won't recognize you as a person. They'll most likely see you as a metal endoskeleton without its costume on. Now, since that's against the rules here at Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, they'll probably try to forcefully stuff you inside a Freddy Fazbear suit. Now, that wouldn't be so bad if the suits themselves weren't filled with cross beams, wires, and animatronic devices, especially around the facial area. So you can imagine how having your head forcibly pressed inside one of those could cause a bit of discomfort and death. The only parts of you that would likely see the light of day again would be your eyeballs and teeth that pop out the front of the mask. Yeah, they don't tell you these things when you sign up. But hey, first station of the breeze. I'll chat with you tomorrow. Check those cameras and remember to close the doors only if absolutely necessary. Gotta conserve power. Alright, good night.
Okay, yeah, I wasn't talking through the first bit of the game because I wanted you guys to hear what, oh god damn it. Hi there, friend. Hey, Bonnie. Don't you dare move. Actually, what am I kidding? I know he's gonna move. But I wanted you guys to hear what the phone guy was saying, just so, you know, those who are new here, they can, breeze through the game without having to, Like, they can understand what's going on. Actually, they probably won't understand what's going on. Yeah. Yeah, one thing I never understood, like, why is this camera disabled? That's something I never understood. Okay. Okay. Oh god, he moved. Oh, hi, friend.
Oh, hi, Mark.
Hi, friend.
I did not hit her.
Oh, no. God damn it. Oh, Sheik is out too. Oh. Oh boy, Bonnie's then coming after me. Oh no. Oh. Hey. Hey there, chicken. It's 4 a.m., so I should be good about this. They're not moving. Okay. Nope, they didn't move again. Oh, you want her back in the supply closet? Oh, hi. Hi there. Oh god. You're coming this way. And Bonnie's coming this way. I know it. Don't move. Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, second night. There we go. I'll do like three nights in this episode, and then I'll do another three nights in the next one. Oh god, more phone guy. Oh, he's already out. Yeah, they're not.
Interestingly enough, Freddy himself doesn't come off stage very often. I've heard he becomes a lot more active in the dark, though. So, hey, I guess that's one more reason not to run out of power, right? I also want to emphasize the importance of using your door lights. There are blind spots in your camera view, and those blind spots happen to be right outside your doors. So if you can't find something or someone on your cameras, check the door light. You might only have a few seconds to react. Not that you would be in any danger, of course. I'm not implying that.
There is.
Also, check on the curtain in Pirate Cove from time to time. The character in there seems unique in that he becomes more active if the cameras remain off for long periods of time. I guess he doesn't like being watched. I don't know. Anyway, I'm sure you have everything under control. Talk to you soon.
Okay. So, yeah, Bonnie's in the supply closet, so. It's amazing that all this was made by, like, one guy. Like, okay, Pirate Cove is still there. Okay, well. No one's moving. Like, Bonnie's not moving. Probably shouldn't be using power so much. Oh, Jake is moving.
Hello.
No! Jeez. Still there. Why is he still there? Go away. Go away, dude. Okay. Thank you. Okay, he's in the backstage area. Yeah, Chica's in the kitchen. Oh, 3 a.m. I'm doing good this round. No. Oh. There he is. Come on, go away. Okay, thank you. Oh, jeez. Where is he this time? Okay, West Hall Corner. So he should be popping up at the door anytime soon. Okay, he's moved to the supply closet. Jake is moving. That body is definitely moving. Okay, there he is. Jake is still there. Okay. I'm sorry if I'm not talking as much as I'd like to. Okay. Yeah, that music I so desperately hate. Okay. Come on. Where are you? Okay. Bonnie and Chica are in. Oh! God dang it. Oh, there he comes. Here he comes. Oh no, I'm about to run out of power. You probably can't see my power count because it's like right behind my head. Okay. Word of advice is don't let that happen. Or maybe let that happen. Okay. Night three. Here we go. Okay, what's that Bumbo gotta say now?
But most people don't last this long. I mean, you know, they usually move on to other things by now. I'm not implying that they die. That's not what I meant.
Oh god, Foxy's already making a run for it.
Playing
How did Chica just make the jump there already? I mean, I know I'm gonna be seeing her anytime soon. Oh god.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Oh my god.
Okay. Looks like I failed. Looks like I failed that. Oh man. Do I even want to keep going? I'd rather not. Yeah, I'll pick this up in another episode. Let me know what you think of this. Let me know about
Ulster's
new work. So, I would really appreciate it if you would leave some nice comments about him. And yeah, let's just leave it at that. Oh my god. I think I need a minute. Okay. Thank you all for watching. Donate to my Patreon. Support me on Ko-fi. Follow me on Twitter and social media websites like Instagram. And also subscribe to me on YouTube and turn on the notification bell so you'll be notified of whenever I upload a new video. Anyway, good night, everybody. Oh my god.